how does the law interpret this? And the phone call records, which I would have read out, Arnab, you have already mentioned, the timing is very, very crucial here. If Mr. Vyas wants to analyze
read
the entire
one month, I want time data.
May I?
Brinda, I want time data. I want time data.
What do you mean time data?
Time data. Are they supposed
to time data? Will you please listen?
Time
you
data
will,
means
Mr. Vyas,
time,
you will
what
have
is
to
time
learn
data?
To hear.
Time data,
what is time data?
No,
time data,
you are only time interrupting
explain,
because
Arnab,
you're scared of what
month
is going to come out.
You can't read this.
Yes,
no,
you
no,
will
no,
get
you
what
can't
you want.
Read this in isolation.
You will get what you want.
It is absolutely wrong. It is absolutely wrong.
You can't you tell Mr. Vyas to learn to hear?
You can't read this in isolation.
I'm not going to.
No court will hold this proof as valid.
Nobody reads anything in isolation. Mr. Jayanarayan, just stop
it. You can't read it in isolation.
Scared. The entire month's call data record has been filed with the first charge sheet. Has the BJP not bothered to look at the first charge sheet? What is going on in the BJP legal
then
cell?
Then why are you mentioning it in isolation?
Long letters to the Prime Minister?
Sorry.
Nobody is mentioning anything in isolation. You don't have the time to hear because of what you will hear is fatal to Gujarat government. That is where the investigation
no
is going and you are running scared. Please do not interrupt now. There was no call between on 2nd June or 3rd June. I've been asked to speak, Mr. Vyas.
Let us speak, sir.
There was no call on 5th June, on 6th June, on 7th June. There are calls on 10th June. The timing is very interesting, as read out by Mr. Arnab Goswami, 22:57, which means 10:57 p.m. Just when the entire planning for the extrajudicial killing, cold-blooded murder of four people in prior custody has taken place. The next call.
This is not
is
established.
On
this is
the
not established. As a lawyer, you should not say this.
The next call is.
This is not
call
established.
Is on the morning immediately after the encounter. It's part of the charge sheet, Mr. Dianara, and we have spent a little bit of time reading papers rather than throwing things in the air. What is the relationship of a boss?
I have got entire
yes,
bunch
Banjara
of papers, madam. You know the matter. This matter is sub judice, and you can't
this
sit over the judgment.
Amit Shah becomes
judgment is the prerogative.
Culpable.
Judgment is the
if
prerogative
the
of court. It is not your prerogative. You are being judgmental.
Can Mr. Vyas be please put into some kind of discipline unless
Mr. Vyas, let her complete and then I assure you I will come back to you, please.
You be disciplined.
Well, let her complete because she did not interrupt you when you were speaking. So let her do that. She's raising a question about the phone call records. Let's go into the details of the phone call records.
But
and the question at this point of time in the News Hour debate, ladies and gentlemen, is this. One minute. On the debate tonight, 1 second, Brinda Grover. On the debate tonight, the debate between the BJP representative and Ishra Jahan's lawyer, Brinda Grover, is on the point of the several phone calls which are part of the record between Amit Shah and Vanzara. And the argument being made on one side is that Vanzara was neither ATS chief nor chief of the crime branch. He was just a DIG. There are 28 such DIGs in the state of Gujarat. So the onus is on the Home Minister to explain why he was speaking to a middle-level officer who has now been proven to committing a crime at that very moment, which is that of an encounter. The BJP representative, ladies and gentlemen, is saying that's part of his job. Now, we continue the debate with Brinda Grover continuing to make her point. Go ahead, Ms. Grover.
Well, the point about boss and subordinate, as articulated by Mr. Vyas, in law, how do we interpret that? Law says that if there is superior responsibility here, which creates criminal culpability. If the junior officer, the subordinate officer, is under the effective control and authority of the superior, and the superior has knowledge that the subordinate is either about to commit a crime or has committed a crime, then there is criminal culpability that gets created for the superior officer here, being Amit Shah. It is their own articulation a little while back. This is a boss-subordinate relationship. The call record data, the statement of DYSP DH Goswami, recorded under 164 before a metropolitan magistrate in Mumbai, very clearly says that Vanjara says, I have taken the approval of the chief minister and the home minister. My grouse as the lawyer for Shamima Kausar is that in fact there was enough material in the first charge sheet to investigate both against Amit Shah and Narendra Modi. Why has the CBI delayed it for so long?
Okay, now Jayanarayan Vyas, very briefly before I go on to others, please, on the debate. I only want to make a point
number
to Brinda
one,
Grover,
Arnab,
that if you're going
Arnab,
entirely by the letter of Vanzara, then I would
making,
like to tell you
yes,
that...
No, I am
points
not going by the letter
I'm
of Mr. Vanzara at all. I am not relying on Vanzara.
Because you are aware that if you are going by the letter of Vanzara, then in my view, and we have disagreed on this in the past.
I am not even looking at the letter of Vanzara. Well, I am not even looking at Vanzara's letter. There is no need to look at it.
Then where is the fresh evidence? Because a case can be reopened only if there is fresh evidence. In the case of Pawan Kumar Bansal, the BJP demanded.
No. You are on the wrong line here.
How?
Please understand, in the charge sheet filed, before the magistrate in Ahmedabad on 4th July, it was categorically stated by the CBI that permission taken to file a supplementary charge sheet under section 173, subsection 8 of the Code of Criminal Procedure. The case is not being reopened. The case was never closed. It's mentioned in the first charge sheet. Please read it.
Well, you know, all I know is that a person can be convicted on the basis of extrajudicial confessions only if such evidence inspires confidence or is by any nature...
I am not relying on extrajudicial confessions.
Or is corroborated by...
Forget DG Vanzara. Forget DG
Why?
Vanzara.
I thought DG Vanzara is the core. How can you now say forget DG Vanzara? I thought DG Vanzara's letter was the core of this debate.
That is not a piece of evidence.
One second. The BJP wants to come back to the debate. It's not. Of course it doesn't. The BJP wants to come back. Yes, Jayanarayan Vyas.
I have 3 points, Arnab. Number one, this is a matter being adjudicated. So to be judgmental and say that Amit Shah was in full know of this thing is something, I think, very becoming very, very presumptive. That is number one. Number two, in exceptional cases where the operating officers at the ground level and the concerned superior of him thinks it fit to be in touch with each other as a practice, it is in number of cases, not only the DIG, DIG crime, DIG ATS, divisional magistrates, that is collectors, This is a sad practice that they normally don't go through.
So you are completely sure of the Amit Shah case?
So it
you are therefore completely sure of the Amit Shah case?
Wrong.
Then answer one question. 1 minute. If you are so completely sure of the Amit Shah case.
Let me complete, Adam.
No, Mr. Vyas.
Why you want to cut me in the middle?
Because we need to go to the politics of it. And the politics of it merits one question. And that question to you is this. 1 minute.
As it is.
Sir, the question
as
to you is this.
Now I'm 1-3.
No, it's not. The question.
And now I'm becoming 1-4.
No, those are, you know, you must not. Those you're hallucinating then. I'm not in the business of, encouraging people to hallucinate on the program.
No, you are cutting me. My argument gets gone.
No, your argument is not gone. If you are conceding that your argument is gone, then it's very dangerous indeed. As a good lawyer, you should not do that.
You are so assertive.
No,
Arnab, you are so assertive.
Mr. Vyas.
I forget my argument.
No, Mr. Vyas, the problem is that the BJP has suddenly decided to clam up. Let me tell you something. Today, the BJP has decided to clam up, which I find very interesting because I have letter after letter, article after article of Arun Jaitley saying that the Congress strategy in the face of depleting popularity is that you cannot fight Narendra Modi politically and hence misuse investigating agencies and implicate Modi and his former Home Minister Amit Shah. Today, your party, Mr. Jayanarayan Vyas, is not saying Amit Shah equals BJP equals Modi equals 2014 campaign. You are very interested. Admit it. Admit it tonight. Admit it, Jayanarayan Vyas, that you are building a line of deniability.
Not the least.
You are building a line of deniability between your chief minister and his ex-associate.
Absolutely not. This is your assumption.
You're going to drop him like a hot potato if he gets into trouble. Admit it.
Is it my time to speak or still you are going to speak?
No, I don't know whether the admission will come.
No, not the least. I am telling you, your first question, that why are we so apprehensive
about CBI? Amit Shah equals BJP?
Now, it is a known fact.
So Amit Shah equals BJP?
I'm replying you. Why? Arnab, would you not please permit me to tell why we are apprehensive and why we don't believe in the standing and independency of the CBI? Begin from Kotrochi's case. How Kotrochi was let off. Then go to... Now Brinda, if you meant what you are saying, your words, please don't intercept me.
Not intercept.
You are saying something and behaving differently.
It's called interrupt. I don't intercept anyone. It's called interrupt.
Please keep quiet. I told interrupt. If you have problem with your ears, better you get them checked. I never mess up with my English. So please hear me correctly and don't stop me in between. Number one, Adab, that right from Kotrochi, to Mayawati's improportionate property case, to Mulayam's improportionate property case, to Jagan Mohan's default bail, to the default bail of Mr. Singhal. You know, there are series of cases which make you believe that there is not going to be a fair play as far as you are concerned. And therefore, if Mr. Jetley writes a letter, he is simply conveying the apprehensions that the party has of that CBI being misused. As the Congress is increasingly getting nervous, today's rumor you must have seen. Now they are thinking of Priyanka Gandhi being fielded. Rajiv Gandhi doesn't seem...
So why are you clutching at rumors to make your argument?
So,
why are you clutching at rumors?
No, I'm not. I'm saying, I have given you five examples why we have apprehensions. And why CBI is not Central Bureau of Investigation, it is Congress Bureau of Investigation.
I have given five good valid cases.
I am no fan of the CBI, but
you know the point is, Mr. Amit Shah, you totally and completely ducked my question, which was about the BJP sudden silence on Amit Shah's interrogation. Mr. Vyas, 1 minute.
Not the least. Amit Shah is capable of fighting his case.
Oh, wonderful. This is the first time I've heard that Amit Shah is capable of fighting his case. Second line of deniability.
And as a party colleague, as a party leader, if you call that so far so, Brinda must know that any accused, so far so it is proven guilty in the court of law. This is the basic principle of jurisprudence, that he is innocent. And if there is any innocent person who is our leader, we stand solidly behind him.
Ami Agnik, explain this. On Saturday, Narendra Modi is going to Kanpur. He's going to address his first rally in Uttar Pradesh. Amit Shah is Uttar Pradesh BJP in charge. Uttar Pradesh is the key state for the BJP, right? The Congress is going to get into a tie-up with Mayawati, 99% certain. Only the formality of the announcement is left. You know there is a fixed match going on between certain groups in the VHP and the Samajwadi Party, and hence your entire strategy is somehow to torpedo the BJP's Uttar Pradesh campaign by getting Amit Shah into trouble. Because otherwise I cannot understand, an ineffective, incompetent group body like the CBI, which drags its feet for decades in cases, suddenly getting its act together beautifully. You know, last minute. It does three things. It clears Mayawati in the disproportionate assets case. It clears Mulayam Singh Yadav in the case against him, decides not to take it any further. And it moves at breakneck, Formula One speed on Amit Shah. Is the CBI trying to fight the Uttar Pradesh elections? Ami Agnik, that it's going ahead with such a great
two
focus
points.
On Uttar Pradesh?
Yes. Two points, Arna. One, you're presuming too much about all kinds of permutations and combinations.
What is a presumption?
It is not the right time to talk about that. That is the first thing. Second thing, no, you said that there is going to be a tie-up and there is going to be this and that.
Of course there's going to be a tie-up. Everyone knows it.
Second point, Mr. Shah, Second point, Mr. Shah has gone to UP and he has gone as a national secretary of the BJP. And with this kind of a checkered history and track record, his entry into UP, you know what has happened at Muzaffarnagar. And so that is, it speaks a lot about the whole thing. And the third point is that there is no breakneck speed. I told you earlier also, there is enough material gathered by the judicial magistrate of Gujarat and there is enough material by the SIT appointed by the Gujarat High Court, which said and came to a conclusion that there have been fake encounters and as many as 22 police officers are involved. The Gujarat cops have investigated. That is the same material before the CBI, and so the CBI is now investigating step by step on all that material gathered. And you have to understand one thing, that the call details were erased, they were not given to the CBI, and now the call records have come with the explosive letter of DG Vanjara, which says that he was inspired, guided and monitored by his political bosses. They have used him and thrown him away. Please stand by my side. That is what his resignation letter says. And so there is no breakneck speed.